I saw the nakedness of these children of God. Why nakedness? This make me remember what Moses saw when he was coming from the mountain. He saw the people of Israel naked. Why? Because they worship another God. Because of their idol before God, they were naked. So these children of God I saw them half naked because of the sin in their life. Because they worship another God. And I saw how Jesus was hiding his face. No! And they were trying to touch Jesus. Jesus was saying, you know, Jesus was running away from them because of their nakedness. Jesus could not go towards them. As they were saying, Jesus, take us with you. Take us with you. Jesus was saying, no, my church is dirty. I can't go in. Do you see, my sister? The Lord allow me to see this so I can come and share with you. The nakedness in the church. The nakedness in the life of many children of God in the church. And where I was standing, I said, hey, children of God. Hey, so nobody is worthy. And I remember that before I saw this vision in that same revelation, the Lord took me around the world. In different country, he said, in this country, only one is my child. In this country, only one is my child. So in this revelation, I was so afraid. I said, with the numerous Christians we see all over the world, churches, many churches that are opening, only one. Truly, the Bible says that only few will enter through the narrow way. The narrow way. The church is full of people, but only few people are going towards the direction that God have laid before us. Do you understand what I say? I was standing and I was crying. I said, nobody is worthy. I saw the eyes of Jesus, how Jesus Christ was crying. Jesus was crying, saying, my church is dirty. I can't go in. I woke up. When I woke up, my dear, I was crying for my own soul. I said, Jesus, any sin in my life, oh God, have mercy on me. Take it away. Any dirtiness in my life, oh God, take it away. And I woke up like this. Many sisters, they were around me. They saw what was happening. There's even one sister that recorded everything that happened. Do you understand? I ran to in the other room. I told the sister, the church is dirty. The church is dirty. They asked me, which church? What was the name of the church? I said, that church has no name. This is the church of Jesus, the body of Christ. My dear sister, if you look at the churches today, many abominations in the church. There's no more fear of God. Many false doctrinaires enter the church today. People have the Christianity today. You cannot differentiate between Christianity and worldliness. Many idols in our lives instead of God. I began to cry for myself. I cried to God. I said, God, what is the nakedness in the church? As I was praying like this, 1 month later, you know, before the Lord showed me what I'm going to explain to you, something happened before that June. I was coming back from church. It was on Sunday. I have to explain to you all the encounter I had with the Lord for you to know that God, Jesus Christ is coming soon. And we, the children of God, we need to prepare ourselves. This Sunday, I came back home with my children. After eating, you know, normally after Sunday fellowship, we have to go and rest and go back to another fellowship in the evening. So I went to rest. As I went to rest, suddenly I saw a horse in my room. You see, I was scared when I saw this horse. The horse was white, totally white, and he was standing before me. I stood up from my bed, and I said to myself, this is not a dream. This is real. I was scared, and I began to tie the horse. I say, in the name of Jesus, I bind you in the name of Jesus. And immediately I heard the voice of God speaking to me in my heart and saying that stop binding the horse. This is a good horse. Look at him in the eyes. As I look at him in the eyes like this, the horse would run. You know, he entered me as if, you know, we are going to conquer. Do you understand? He entered me like this, and immediately I began to go up, 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 up. I saw the earth was full of darkness. Darkness was covering the earth. But through that darkness, I could see a man holding a cutlass, killing another human being. You know, I was trying to tell to that man, I said, look, what you are doing is a sin. You are killing your fellow brother. Stop it. God do not like it. But that man could not hear me. And I was, you know, when I noticed that he could not hear me, I was disturbed because I was screaming. I said, look, you are killing your fellow brother. Stop it. Then this voice that traveled with me, although I could not see him, I knew this was the voice of the Holy Spirit. This was the voice of God. He said to me, look, Claire, this man cannot hear you. You can see him. You can see what he's doing. But he cannot see you. You know? I said, it means that I'm dead. Oh, please, I don't want to die now. I have 3 children. I am a single mother. Please have mercy. Bring me back. Bring me back to my bed. Bring me back to my children. I don't want to die. Because we were standing in the sky, and I could see the earth was covered with a thick darkness. But inside that thick darkness, I could see this man, you know, killing another man. And the voice spoke to me. He said, Claire, do you know why the earth is full of darkness? He said, it is sin that has covered the earth. People are living in sin. That is how God sees the earth. That is how God sees the earth. The Bible said that we are the light of the world. Truly, we are the light of the world. Because in that darkness, that thick darkness, I could see small, small light. And I knew this were the children of God. And after, a cloud cover the thick darkness. Another cloud, we passed that first cloud, and then we went to the second cloud, and then we went to the third cloud. That is where I stopped. I stopped, and I remember, I say, so heaven is so beautiful. I was able to touch the cloud like you are touching this Bible. I say, the cloud. So heaven is beautiful. I was touching the floor. I was touching the cloud. I was admiring the cloud. And suddenly, the same voice that traveled with me, I knew that was the voice of the Holy Spirit, because that voice was peaceful. It's like it's my best friend. It's like I know this voice for a long time. Do you understand? He spoke to me and said, Claire, look behind you. I turned around. I saw this angel. The angel was very tall, very, very tall. And he was wearing a long white robe. The angel was coming towards me, singing a very glorious melody, praising the Lord. And I look at the angel. I was admiring the angel. I was admiring the song, the beautiful song, beautiful melody that is praising God. I was carried by the beauty. I was praising God. And immediately the angel vanished. When the angel disappeared, this voice said to me, Claire, the angel is there, but your eyes cannot see the angel. But the angel is still there. When you will go down there, on earth, I will always be with you. You will not see me with your eyes, your physical eyes, but I want you to know that I'm always around you. I will be with you every day of your life. Hallelujah. Then when he spoke like that, then he said, look up. I look up. I saw heaven. I saw another heaven, and I saw 2 eyes. I don't know how to explain it, but I pray God, the Spirit of God will explain it to you more than me. I just have to tell you what I saw. I saw 2 eyes in the cloud, 2 nostrils, the eyes, and the mouth. Here was cloud, Here was cloud. Here was cloud. Everywhere was cloud. The hair was white like clouds. Cloud everywhere. But I could see only two eyes, nursery, and the mouth. The mouth was speaking. Where I was standing, I was shaking. It's just like if that mouth just do like this, I will vanish away. Do you understand? I was scared. And the mouth spoke. It said, Claire. You know, what made me scared is that the mouth speak like many voice. It was like thunder. It spoke. It said, Claire and done. Claire and done. You are not worthy to be here. Ah, in my heart, I say, I'm not worthy to be here. But I've given my life to Jesus. This is the question. Many people have given their life to Jesus, but on that day they will not be worthy. Me, that time I gave my life to Jesus, but God was saying that I'm not worthy. I was asking myself, I said, I've given my life to Jesus. Jesus died for me, but I'm not worthy. Is it a mistake? He said, you are not worthy. And when he spoke like that, I saw another man standing at his right hand. In the position, bending position, he was bent like this and he was crying. He said, Father, give me 2 minutes. Only 2 minutes. I still have people on earth. I still have people in Cameroon. I still have people in Nyland. He was giving name. He was giving. He said, give me 2 minutes. Only 2 minutes. I was standing. He was pleading for my sake, begging God for God to give him 2 minutes. Immediately, I know that the request was, his prayer was granted because my phone rang. Hallelujah. When my phone rang, I woke up from my bed. I woke up from my bed and I picked the phone. I told my friend, I said, look, my sister, her name is Blessing. Sister Blessing, call me back, call me back. I am in heaven. She said, sorry. I will call you later. That was it. I knelt down. I said, God, bring me back again. Bring me back. Because, and you know, this it was not a dream. It was real. This happened in a daylight time around 4 p.m. My dear sister, I began to think in my life. I said, what is that thing in my life that God said I'm not worthy? This happened before the Lord showed me the revelation of my church is dirty. And I contacted my brother Eve. Brother Eve, I would like Brother Eve to testify this, that I called him and I told him, I said, brother, this is what I saw. I saw Jesus Christ saying that my church is dirty, my church is dirty. Do you understand? I told him, I said, brother, I saw Jesus Christ saying that, telling God, God, give me only 2 minutes. I know that it's only 2 minutes that remain. All I can do for God is to sing. Brother, since you know you know how to record people, I will come, you will record my voice. I want to sing for God. So for me, I knew that there is not much time. Maybe God allowed me to come back so that I could sing for him, because I was looking for the kind of sin in my life that will make me not worthy. I do not know that there are many things in my life that God wants me to understand. Do you understand? Because in the church, they never told me that. In the church, they were saying that everything was okay when I gave my life to Jesus. Do you understand? So, now, when I saw this revelation, my church is dirty, I began to pray, cry, Jesus, what is that thing that is dirty in my life, in our life, in the church? Oh, God, reveal to me anything in my life. I called that same brother Eve, Naisha Kiye. Hallelujah. When I called him, he took his car and he drove in my house. He said, this one, you should put it on YouTube. Let all the church hear this message. This is how he put the message on YouTube. I don't know how God began to spread the message. Many people began to call me, my dear sister, it is the Lord that spoke to you. Truly, we knew that something is wrong with the church. The way things are happening in the church, we knew that God is not happy. People began to ask themselves, God, what is that thing that is dirty? You understand? The Lord was about to reveal something in the life of, in our life. The Lord was about to open the eyes of many children of God. I thank the Lord. I was praying in my secret. I said, God, show me the dirtiness in the church. Show me the dirtiness in the church. Show me the dirtiness in the church. Show me the nakedness in the church. What has made us naked? I saw many children of God crying, Jesus, take us with you. But we're not ready. We are not ready, Jesus. We don't want to make you cry again. Have mercy, Lord. Show me the dirtiness in the church. As I was praying like this, my dear sister, July passed. August. It was then in August that I saw what I'm going to tell you now. In this revelation, I saw myself going to visit a pastor. I entered the house of this pastor. I greeted him. I said, "Hello, sir. Sir, sorry, I am thirsty. I want to drink water." Then the pastor said, "Sure, if you go in the garden, you will see water." There is a well. Then I went in the garden. I saw this well. I was going towards this well. The well looked familiar to me. So as I was going to look for the fetch the water in the well, a voice spoke inside me. It said, "This well, there is a strange power in this hell." I stood. He said, "There is a strange power in this well." I stood, and then I began to pray. "Lord God, my Father, any strange power in this well, manifest yourself in the name of Jesus." I was praying with all my strength. "Any strange power inside this well, manifest yourself in the name of Jesus, manifest yourself in the name of Jesus." As I was praying like this, I saw a creature coming from that well out like this, slowly like this. It was a woman. She was, you know, proud like this. I could see small children around her inside that well like that. She was so proud, and she looked at me boldly in my eyes. She said, "What do you want from me?" I said, "So I am coming to drink water from this well every time you are here." She said, "Yes. Each time you are coming to drink from this well, you drink from me. I'm watching you." She said to me, "What do you want from me? You are not the one that will ask me to leave this well." Ha! When she spoke like this, holy anger, I began to pray. I said, "In the name of Jesus, come out from this well. Come out from this well in the name of Jesus. Come out from this well in the name of Jesus." As I was praying like this, the fire came out of my body, the fire came out from my body like this. And the fire began to, went to consume her. She resisted. She resisted the fire. She said, "Listen, I told you, you are not the one that will ask me to come out from this well. Go and ask the women. Those women that allow me to enter this well, they are the only one that will allow me to go." I said, "What?" I was looking to see if there are women. I was told that they've gone to market to buy some stuff. What are the women going to do in the market? What are they buying in the market? I was asking myself, and then I began to pray again. I said, "In the name of Jesus, come out from that well. I command you in the name of Jesus." She said, "I told you." Do you know, Satan has a hold on you if you allow him, if you give him a legal right. She was claiming a legal right. She said, "The women are the one that brought me here, so they are the one that will remove you, me, not you." Then I asked her, I said, "Look, what is your mission in the church?" She said, "My mission is to quench the fire of God in the life of ministers of God." When I heard like this, I said, "In the name of Jesus, come out from this well." I was praying with all my strength. Fire was coming up from my belly. Fire was consuming her. She resisted. I told you, "I will not go. If you want me to go, go and ask the women that allow me to be here. They are the only one that will remove me, not you." I was praying. My dear sister, what is the well? The well represents the fountain that feeds your soul. Praise the Lord. The fountain that feeds your soul. Remember the story of the Samaritan woman. The Samaritan woman and Jesus at the Jacob well. When the Samaritan was going to fetch water, she met Jesus. She was going to draw water from a well. And there she met Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. To cut the story short, this is what Jesus told her. Jesus said, "Whosoever drink from this well, shall be thirsty. He shall thirst again. But whosoever drink of the water that I shall give, him shall never thirst. Hallelujah. He shall never thirst. The water coming from that well. That well represents the word of God. The water that Jesus Christ is presenting to us is the water that comes from the throne of God. The water that will feed us spiritually. But Satan now has come to pollute that water. Why? Because of the women. Women have invited the queen of the coast in the church. Today, the church has been polluted because of we women that have invited her in the church. The word of God, the churches have been polluted. This evil spirit began to say, you know, she was boasting, and then she bring out three picture of men of God that I know here in Ireland. She was saying, this one, I've already quenched his fire. This one, I've already quenched his fire. This one, I've already quenched his fire. As he was, I know these men of God. They still have church. People are still going inside the church. But the queen of the coast was laughing and boasting because their fire has been quenched. They are just there, you know, like beating the air. Whatever they are doing, the spirit of God have left them. Hey, when I saw it, I said, let me go and call a pastor. In that dream, I ran, I went to call a pastor. I said, pastor, the queen of the coast has entered the church. Let us go and fight her. I was pulling the pastor. I said, pastor, come. Look, when I arrived now near the well, I saw the, I said, look at the queen of the coast. Look at the queen of the coast. I said, look, she has entered the church. When the queen of the coast saw the pastor, she laughed. You, the pastor took the Bible and he began to do like this. Come out in the name of Jesus. Come out in the name of Jesus. Come out in the name of Jesus. When the pastor was saying, come out in the name of Jesus, she was laughing. She said, you. The fire of God in your life is just like candle. If I do like this, it will go off. I said, pastor, don't you see what she's doing? Fight! Let us fight! Let us fight! The pastor will just take the Bible and do like this. Come out in the name of Jesus. And me with holy anger. I say you, in the name of Jesus, come out! Come out! She said, you, I told you. If you want me to go and ask the women. The women that allowed me to enter, go and ask them to come and remove me here. That is how I woke up. I began to cry and say, hey, God, oh. What has happened in the church? What has the women brought in the church that is giving now the legal ground to the mother of our Lord, the queen of the coast, to boast inside the church? I want us to read in the book of Revelation chapter 17. The book of Revelation chapter 17, verse 4. Hallelujah. I'm reading King James Version. The book of Revelation chapter 17 verse 4. I want to describe this woman called the queen of the coast. Who is she in the Bible? The Bible says, and the woman was arrayed in purple, scarlet color, decked with gold and precious stones and pearls, having a golden cup in her hand, full of abomination and filthiness of her fornication. And upon her forehead was a name written, Mystery, Babylon the Great, the mother of our Lord and abomination of the earth. Verse 6, and I saw the woman drunken with the blood of the saints and with the blood of the martyrs of Jesus. And when I saw her, I wondered with a great admiration. You know, this woman, when you see her physically, she has that evil adornment. And her mission is to seduce men of God in order to quench their fire. The Bible said that she is drunk with the blood of the saint. For her is to kill the fire of God of all the children of God. And this is the woman today. She's sitting in the church. She has entered the well. The well that's supposed to be pure, sanctified. She has polluted the well. The well is the word of God. The fountain that's supposed to feed our soul is not poisoning us. It's not poisoning us. I saw it and I was crying. I was lamenting. I said, oh, in the name of Jesus, come out. When I woke up, my dear sister, I said, what have the women done? What have the women done? That the queen of the coast has entered in the church. The mother of our Lord has entered the church. She's even boasting. I say, I fear. I say, if I tell this thing to people, people will think that I'm mad. I kept it for myself. I told to one or two people, or three people. I told them, I said, this is what I saw. But I kept it because I said, the Lord has already shown me my church is dirty. I was already facing persecution because some people were calling me Joseph the dreamer. So I kept this one for myself, not knowing that the Lord did not show this revelation for me. Hallelujah. He show when God wants to use you, when God wants to speak to you, he will speak to you in a manner that you will understand. He will go step by step. First, when he took me to heaven, I saw how Jesus Christ was interceding for us. And number two, I saw the church, how the church is dirty, how the people are naked. And number three, now he's showing me how the queen of the coast has entered the church, how the well that was supposed to be sanctified has been polluted because of women. Women? That was my question. Lord, why women? I do not understand. I do not understand. August passed. The month of August passed. September. September was that month of revelation. When God revealed to me the plain truth. When God revealed to me what he wanted me to do. That 3rd September 2011. It was in the middle of the night. In the middle of my sleep. The Lord, I saw myself standing in the clouds with the angel of God, the messenger of the Lord. But the Lord sent his messenger, and the messenger was dressed as a woman for me to understand the message he has for me, the message he has for all the women, the message he has for the church. I was standing with her. She called my name and said, Claire Andun, you are on your way to heaven. The way of holiness. Holiness is the only way to heaven. As she was speaking like this, I remember the Bible verse that said that without holiness, no man shall see the Lord. I was standing with her. Then she said to me, she said, two women started like you. But look what happened. She pointed the earth. When she pointed the earth like this, I could see two women. These two women were dressed in a manner, you know, that will bring your attention. Because you see the way me, I used to see in the church how women dress. The women dress, you know, we dress like the world, you know, with trousers, earrings, makeup. But these two women were different. The way they were dressed, they were just looking like this angel of God, because the angel of God appeared with long skirt, very long skirt, and the skirt was the skirt have allowance. You could not see any part of her body, any shape of her body. And she has a top, the sleeve is very long, long sleeve, and it was closed here like that, you know, and it has allowance. And the head, I could not see her hair. I saw she covered her hair the way I cover like this with scarf, you know. And she told me, look at these two women. And these two women were dressed, exactly like the angel of God, like the messenger of God. You understand? And she said, but look at what happened after. I could hear what these two women were speaking. One of them said, my dear, we thank God for what he has done in our life. He has changed us. Yes, he has done so many things, but this message is not for us alone. Let us go and speak to other women that pleasing the Lord, serving God is not only with their mouth. Even their character and their body must say that they are children of God, that they must please the Lord even with their dressing. That is what I heard. And immediately I saw these two women enter a house. In this house, there were many other women, but these women were different from these two women. These women were dressed with, you know, the way we used to dress, the way we dress in the churches today. They were dressed with earrings, all sizes of earrings, big one. I saw women with big earrings, some of them with small size of earrings, some of them with, you know, tiny, you know, with chain, necklace, you know, with them. You know, necklace, some of them were putting bracelets, you know, ring on their finger, and trousers, tight one, loose one, trousers, and the face was full of makeup, lipsticks, eyelashes. You know, I saw the women with the weave on. They were not putting on any head covering. Their head were not covered. They were different from these two women. These women were having hair attachment, wigs, you know, all sort of different hair attachment. But they were praying. They were worshiping God. They were singing praise. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. They were, you know, they were deep in worship. But these two women entered and said, oh, you people are praising God, which is good. It's good. Yes. But the way you people are dressed, God do not like it. God do not like it. Yes, it is good you are praising God. But the way you are dressed, look at your attire. God do not like it. These two women were keep on speaking, keep on talking to them, but they refused to listen to these two women. They continued to worship God. They were worshiping God. They were worshiping God. They were praising God. These two women were keep on talking to them, but they refused to listen to them. Hallelujah. This one, you know, make me understand what I'm going through today. Hallelujah. And the Lord spoke, the angel of God spoke to me after this. When these two women saw that these women refused to listen to them, they got discouraged. They got confused. And one said, look at how these women are so serious in their worship. They are worshiping God, you know. But is it really true that God will send them to hell because of the way they are dressed? Is it true that God will send them to hell because of their weave on? Makeup, earrings, trousers. I'm beginning to doubt. Maybe it's not God that sent us. Let us get out from here. They left that place. They begin to go. They were just so disappointed by the women and they were discouraged. They were confused. Then the messenger of God, I was standing in the cloud with the messenger of God. She said, that is the spirit of confusion among these two women. Now you go. Make sure you don't do the same mistake like these two women. Oh, my dear. Imagine the Lord is sending you to go and do something. Do you understand? These women failed on their mission. And the Lord said, I should go and make sure that I don't fail like these two women. And he said, as for these two women, they are still on earth. Pray for them. So it means that these two women are still on earth. They are not dead. God sent them before me, but they failed on their mission because of the disappointment, because people refused to listen to them. Ow! You know, the angel of God spoke to me. He said to me, make sure you don't get discouraged. My dear sister, if you are on my shoes today, if you know what I'm going through today, because of this message, I am telling you, I've been called all sort of name. Until today, people, they don't even want to see my face. Some people will call me, shut up! You are not married. Go and sit down. You can't preach. Go and sit down. Keep silence. Go look only in the heart. But the Lord spoke to me and said, make sure you don't get discouraged. So this is a mission. This is an assignment God gave to me on that day. Then the angel of God turned to me and said, as for you, you still have debt in your life. Make sure you pay all your debt. Make every effort. That is the word you use. Make every effort to pay all your debt, because God will never accept anyone that refuses to pay his debt. My dear, this is heaven I'm presenting to you now. This is the narrow way that I'm presenting to you, not the broad way people are telling you that God is merciful. God will allow anybody to enter in heaven as long as you have, you know, your heart. Let me tell you, God, on that day, everything that you did here on earth, the Lord would judge you. Let us make sure that this heavenly race we are running will not miss it in the name of Jesus Christ. I stood up from my bed. I said, Jesus, this one, I consider it like a dream. Who am I? Number one, my English is not perfect. I am a French speaking. Number two, for a long time I left my country. My French is dead now. So who? Number three, I'm not graduated. I don't have any PhD. Who will listen to me? And you said I should go and warn the women. Oh God, I will not do it. Anyway, I consider this as a dream. My dear sister, that was how I closed the case. I closed the case, my dear sister. Let me tell you, when God wants to do something, when God wants Jonah to go to Nineveh, if Jonah had to enter the fish, if fish have to swallow Jonah, for Jonah to go to Nineveh, God would do it. The Lord came in the dream and spoke to me. He showed me a church. He showed me a church. They call that church, Church Without World. These people, they have a television channel. And I saw the owner of that television channel. He was standing on the altar preaching. He was standing and preaching. And he said, the young man spoke to me. He said to me, you see these people? The Lord has given given you a message for them. If you fail to give them this warning, if you fail to give them the message the Lord has given to you, their blood is upon your hand. Hi. I woke up. I said, oh God, who am I? I called this television. I called them. They are based in England. I said, this is a revelation God has given to me. Please, you people, stop. Tell the women not to wear earrings. Tell the women to cover their hair. You know, these are the, you know, and this, maybe they do not understand my English. But they told me that, don't worry, we are living a holy life. I look at the way we, our sisters from the white race, sorry to use this word, I just want to differentiate between, you know, from the white race, they don't believe in these things. They pray without covering their hair. They do little makeup. Some of them will do little makeup. Some of them will do makeup everywhere. They will be putting earrings, trousers. In fact, it is scarce to see a white sisters in Christ putting on long skirt. So the thing paid me. I said, Jesus, nobody will believe me. They will not believe me, Lord. I tried to go to some churches here. The way they chased me out, though. The way they chased me out. They say, look, in this church, we believe in holiness. They look at my stature. A single mother like me, with three kids. They do not believe me. I say, God, there is nothing in me that they will believe. My English is not good. Lord, they will not believe me. Find somebody else that will do this work. I refused to do this work, my dear sister. I wanted to be a gospel singer, but the Lord chose this work for me. And another night, the Lord came to me. He showed me, he was dressed in white, pure white. And he showed me two Kenyan women. These Kenyan women were filled with the Spirit of God. They were praying over a Jehovah Witness. They were praying and laying their hand upon the Jehovah Witness, a man. They prophesied over him. And suddenly this man received Christ. He began to speak in tongues. He was baptized in the Holy Ghost. Then this man spoke to me. The Lord spoke to me. He said, Claire, you see these two women? They are my children. But they have not received the message I've given to you. Now, don't push them away. Go to them and give them the message that I've given to you for them. Then I wanted to go to them. He said, don't go that way. Go to the city room and wait for them. So I followed the way the Lord Jesus Christ directed to me. I went and sat down. And these women, when they finished to pray over that Jehovah Witness, this Kenyan woman, they came to me. When they saw me, they said, this is the woman of God, the servant of the Most High God. She has a message for me. I sat them down. When they sat down, I began to say, you people are praising God. It's very good. It's very good. But the way you are dressed, the Lord Jesus Christ is not happy. The Lord Jesus Christ is not happy when you are praying, you are not covering your hair. The Lord is not happy when you are, the way you people have tampered the glory of God with all those fake attachments. Your hair is the glory of God. The Lord is so not happy the way you are making up. You are tampering with the temple of the Holy Ghost. Your body is the temple of the Holy Ghost. Stop putting on makeup. The Lord is not happy the way you people are putting on trousers. The Lord is not happy the way you are dressed ungodly. As I was speaking like this, the women began to remove earrings. Some of them removed their necklace. They were crying, repenting. These women were Kenyan women. I pray one day I'm going to meet these Kenyan women in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. The Lord showed to me that how these Kenyan women love God, but they are still palming their hair. They are still putting on earrings. They are still putting on trousers. The Lord have a message for you, all the Kenyan women. God have message. He say, he see how you are loving him, but the way you are dressed, this is not the way he wants you to dress. The Lord said, I should not push them away. I should not push the women away. Any woman in the church that wear trousers, the Lord has sent me to come and tell you this message. Hallelujah. That is why he has opened this television called Complete Holiness TV to differentiate this message from others, to prepare his church for rapture. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Glory be to the Almighty God. When the Lord gave me this message, he began to speak to me. He said, I should not get discouraged. I will go through a lot. I should not get discouraged. The Lord gave me boldness. I told the Lord I'm going to do it. He gave me boldness. He spoke to me. He said, before you were born, I chose you. I even revealed you to your mom, but your mom kept it as a secret. He said, you will pass through fire. He took a paper like this. You know, it looked like the Torah that the Jews are using. He folded like this. He said, take. I took it. I took it. He said, you will pass through fire, but fire will not burn you. You know, it is now I understand that the fire represents persecution. All I'm going to go through. And the paper represents the word of God that God has put in me, in my mouth. And he used his right hand. He touched the wall, and then fire blew up. He said, go through the fire. So everything I'm going through today, God allowed it. He allowed it. But I am more than a conqueror in the name of Jesus Christ. So he said, go through the fire. I used that word of God he gave to me. I passed through the fire. When I came out from the fire, the dress I was I was putting on were not burnt, even not even a smoke, not even the smell of fire over me. And then the Lord shout hallelujah. He shouted hallelujah. You know, in this revelation, he was tall, very tall, pure white. When he shouted hallelujah, midwife shouted hallelujah, hallelujah. I knew there was victory. I woke up. And know that, you know, this was silly. The Lord was trying to encourage me. One night he came again. In this dream, I saw a sister in Christ. She was singing praise, worship to the Lord. I came to her and said, my sister, you are singing. Do you know I sing for the Lord? She said, I know. The Lord has given you a great voice. But the Lord wants you to do the work that he has given to you. Then, suddenly like this, I saw the Lord touch his flesh. You see? He touched the flesh. He said, go and tell the women that the flesh, their flesh and their desire must die. Go and tell them. Then I said, what about the song? Because I wanted to use the singing as the ministry. But the Lord made me understand that the singing is not the main ministry he has given to me. I can sing. Hallelujah. I can worship him. I can minister. But the main work, he said, focus on the work I have given unto you. Focus on the assignment I've given to you. Go and tell the women that their flesh and their desire must die. And this is about holiness. Hallelujah. Clean the flesh. Allow the Spirit of God to take over. Hallelujah. My dear sister, this is the message the Lord has given to me. Since the day I've started going from church to churches, I started spreading this message on YouTube. My dear sister, I've seen a lot. I've seen a lot. Today, I am on my own. I cannot go to a church. I cannot enter a church like this unless they invite me. I'm not welcome to many churches because of this message. Many people do not want to associate with me because of this holiness. My dear sister, I've lost a lot of friends, even in the body of Christ. What I've seen today, many pastors trying to pull me down, many trying to push me aside because of this message. They would tell their sisters, do not follow her, she's mad. Many of them are declaring fasting for me to die. But the Lord has been disappointing them. Many have come, they came as sheep in our midst. When we are gathering with women, they will come as if they are one of us. When they are wolf, trying to tell the women, why are you people following Claire? She's not educated. It's not God that has called her. They've tried to turn the heart of these women away from following the standard of holiness of God. But I thank the Almighty God that has been there with me, that has been there with us. Without graduation, with the little I know, God put it aside and granted me his wisdom. One day, with all this pressure of men, many pastors that were trying to silence me, I later said, God, I can't do this work. I will allow other men of God to do it. You understand? The Lord spoke to me. He said, Claire, do not worry for what you will say. I will put my word in your mouth. Just open your mouth and begin to speak. That is why I am now preaching the word of God to all the women. Hallelujah. With boldness, knowing that those that God have assigned, hallelujah, they will turn away from worldliness and come to God. We are called the virtuous women in Christ. The women that have been transformed inside and outside. After giving their life to Jesus, we also give our body to Jesus. Hallelujah. This is the message that God has given to me. Praise the Lord. And I'm going to warn the women every day of my life until I die. Nothing will stop me. Nothing will stop me. One day, the Lord Jesus Christ came to me. I was sleeping in my bed. He came in my room. He said, my daughter, I am the one that called you. Go and tell the women that it's because I love them that I'm sending you to them. Tell them it is because I love them that I'm sending you to them. Do only the work that I've assigned to you. Do only the work that I've assigned to you. That is why the Lord is with me. Whatever I do, the Lord is with me. The hand of the Lord is there because he is the one that sent me. I saw myself kneeling before the altar. The Lord took a bottle of oil. He poured on my head. Nobody, no pastor anointed me. No, I was not anointed in the church, but it's the Lord God Almighty that anointed me. He said, kneel down. I knelt down. He took a cup of oil. He was pouring over my head. Then, as he was pouring over my head, he was pouring on top of my scarf. He said to me, remove your scarf. I removed my scarf, and he was pouring my head, oil over my head. The oil was spilling all over my face. Then he said, this bottle of oil I am putting on upon your head. Now, take your scarf. He took the bottle and put it in my head. He said, take your scarf. Tie your hair. He said, the reason why I want you to tie your hair, for the oil, for the anointing to be permanent. So as I spoke like this, I tore my scarf. He put the bottle of the oil in my head, and I took my scarf. I tied my hair scarf. My dear sister, that is why it's so important. When we go before God, let us tie our hair. Hallelujah. It is honoring the Almighty God. Praise the Lord. But the Lord opened my eyes and saw the enemy that was far. He was laughing at me. He said, I will do everything. You will fail at this assignment. You will fail. You will see. Satan vowed. I have to tell you, one day I was sleeping in my room. In the middle of the night, I saw a man that was coming like a thief. You know, Satan is a thief. He come to devour. He come to steal. He come to destroy. He was coming like this, thinking I was sleeping. The Lord opened my eyes. I saw him. When he saw me, I said, what are you doing here? He said, I've been sent to come and kill you. Die! He took his two hands like this, stretching his two hands towards my, because I was sleeping like this. And then he was standing on the other side of the bed, pointing his two hands towards me. And I could not stand. I was like inoptized. Then a voice spoke to me, Claire! Stand up! Fight! The voice was speaking from heaven. A mighty force power came over me. I stood up. Then I stretched my two hands against him. Power against power. But the power of God that was coming throughout my hand was powerful than his own. And when I did, I said, who sent you? He said, he sent me to come and kill you. And then the power that was coming towards his hand, it's like green light. But my heart, my own was fire. When the power that was coming out from my palm was going towards him, he shouted, and he went down on his knees like this. I said, you have the audacity to come in my house, to come to attack me. You will not leave this place without giving your life to Jesus. Now I command you to say, Lord Jesus. He began to say, Lord, 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 Lord. He could not say Lord. He could not say Jesus. I said, so, you are a satanic agent. You could not even say Jesus. In the name of Jesus, I command a fire. Before I say, yeah, hey, because before I say fire, he ran away as if somebody is pursuing him. He was, you know, God showed me. Another night again, I showed the devil himself. He appeared to me. He said, I will do everything. No woman will believe you. Nobody will believe you. You will fail on this assignment. I was holding my Bible like this. And I was standing on top of a bridge. Him and me, he was standing on my left-hand side. He said, I will do everything. You will fall. You will not only fall, you will fail on your assignment. And no woman will believe you. And as he was talking like this, I was holding my Bible, going towards, you know, going forward. I was focused. I was going forward, you know. And I was seeing in front of me a group of women. These women were dressed with, you know, cover. The head was covered. no earrings, no makeup. They well dressed, well covered, long sleeve with long dresses. The dress were not tight. The skirt were long. These women were standing waiting for me. Two lane, left and right. And in the middle of that lane, they spread a white cloth. They were waiting for me. But this man was saying that, this devil was saying that I will not make it. He will do everything. I was walking and suddenly the bridge where I was standing collapsed. And he found himself to the other side. I was standing. You know, when the bridge collapsed, he thought I'm going to collapse as well. But he was shocked because I was still holding to that edge of the bridge. That little tiny edge, you know, that tiny road, that narrow road. I began to walk towards that narrow road, that narrow, the edge. I hold my Bible and I was holding the edge like this, little by little. And Satan was making noise. He said, I told you, you will fall. Nobody will believe you. He was doing like this. He was doing like this, making sure that I would die, that I would fall. But I made it. Hallelujah. I walked through the end. I made it. And when I walked to the end, the women began to shout. I walked towards that, the middle like this. They were spreading the white cloth. I was walking and I was going to up a hill. And then up there, an angel of God was waiting for me and gave me a white cloth. I wore the white cloth. I saw Satan was ashamed of himself. The Lord will put the enemy to shame in the name of Jesus Christ. Many women have been going to hell, but today, from today, the Lord is delivering you today in the name of Jesus Christ. I said, the Lord that has sent me to warn the women and prepare the women for heaven in total holiness is going to be with me. Because what I saw, one day the Lord showed me, I saw the book was open. This lady was standing before the throne of God, before the book of life. Her name was not written. The angel of God looked at her name in the Bible, in the book of life. Her name was not there. And I saw this woman. When the angel of God told her, Madam, your name is not here. She said, Chet. I belong to so church. I go to so church. I am a strong believer. The angel said, yes, you are a strong believer. We know that you go to so church. We know you were born again. But when you were on earth, they told you to stop wearing trousers. You said, no, it's not a sin. They told you to stop putting makeup. You said, no, it's not a sin. We told you to, when you pray, cover your hair. You said, no, God does not look at it. We said, don't put on trousers. Don't put on makeup. You die and you appear. That woman died and appeared the same way she died. This, if you dress like an harlot, don't expect to appear like an angel after you die. Because all your actions follow you even after death. I am telling you the truth today. If your pastor never revealed this truth to you, today the Lord is opening your ear for you to understand. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. My dear sister, let me come back again. When the angel of God told me that I still have debt in my life. You know, I want to talk about the debt in my life. Restitution. Nobody taught me that if you are a child of God, after giving your life to Jesus, if you have any debt, you must pay your debt. What I used to hear, they say, oh God, Jesus has paid all our debt. Once you become born again, even the debt, forget. You don't need to pay them. So, after seeing this revelation, I called one pastor. I said, sir, in this revelation, they said I should pay my debt. He said, clear the dreamer. Jesus the dreamer, forget. You are too much thinking. Forget about your debt. Jesus has paid your debt. I remember I own like one woman there, I own 500. Whenever I see that woman, if I see her coming, I have to change the road. Hey, how will I face that woman if Jesus Christ have paid my debt? Why this woman is still pursuing me with her money? in this revelation. I saw the Lord show me another revelation. I stole a woman's pocket. And I took the pocket and said, ah, with this money, I'm going to serve the Lord. Then I began to run, trying to hide myself. As I was running, I saw this ugly creature running behind me, you know, coming towards me. I look at him. Then a voice said, who told you that you can serve God with this, with the money of somebody in your hand? If you want to serve God, go and give that money back. That is when I turned back. I went to give the money back. And that ugly creature was saying, no, don't go. I said, so you are trying to stop me from making heaven, eh? I went and I gave the money back. And when I gave the money back, that woman prayed for me. I woke up. The restitution, my sister, is something that we need to consider. Praise the Lord. So, I want us to go in the book of Genesis chapter 20. Praise the Lord. Genesis chapter 20 from verse 2. If you are there, open your Bible with me. Genesis chapter 20 verse 2. Together we are going to read. Amen. I'm going to start from verse 1. And Abraham journeyed from thence towards the south country and dwelt between Kadesh and Shur and sojourned in Gerar. And Abraham said to Sarah his wife, she is my sister. And Abimelech, king of Gerar, sent and took Sarah. Verse 3. But God came to Abimelech in a dream by night and said to him, behold, thou art but a dead man. For the woman which thou hast taken, for she is a man's wife. Verse 4. But Abimelech had not come near her. And he said, Lord, will thou slay also a righteous nation? Verse 5. Said he not unto me, she is my sister. And she, even she herself said, he is my brother. In the integrity of my heart and innocency of my hands have I done this. Verse 6, and God said unto him in a dream, yea, I know that thou didst this in the integrity of their heart, for I also withheld thee from sinning against me. Therefore, suffer I thee not to touch her. Now, therefore, restore the man his wife, for he is a prophet, and he shall pray for thee, and thou shalt live. And if thou restore her not, now no doubt that shall surely die, thou and all that are dying. Hallelujah. And therefore, Abimelech rose early in the morning and called all his servants and told all these things in their ears, and the men were so afraid. You see, this is Abimelech. This is Abraham. Hallelujah. He told Abimelech that Sarah is his sister. Sarah told Abimelech that Abraham is his brother. Abimelech believed them. And he took Sarah to be his wife. But in the dream, the Lord Jesus Christ, God came in the dream and said to Abimelech, you know what? You are a dead man. Because you took the wife of somebody. That woman is the wife of Abraham. Abraham, you better restore the wife of Abraham or else you are dead. Then Abimelech said, I did this out of ignorance. Should you punish even a righteous man? Then the Lord said that, yes, that is why I did not kill you. But now I'm commanding you to go back now, restore the wife. If not, you will die. Okay. My dear, he did this by ignorance. And because of his ignorance, God spared his life. Now, God is coming to him, opening his eyes and say, look, this is what you did in ignorance. You are a dead man. if you die now, you cannot see me. But I'm giving you a second chance. Go and restore the wife. Go and restore the wife of Abraham. Praise the Lord. The Lord said to him that I spare your life because you did it ignorantly. My dear sister, me myself, if I knew that debt can send somebody to hell, I would not indulge myself in debt. Now, after giving my life to Jesus, the Lord made me understand that, you know, because he overlooked my ignorance. But now that I know the truth, he commands me to go and restore all the money that I took from people, all the money that I owe people. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Why am I saying this? Because somebody will say, no, I did this. I married that married man out of ignorance. I stole that item out of ignorance. So God overlooked my ignorance. Now I'm living a new life. Why should I go and give back the money? Why should I go and restore back the husband of that woman? Why should I go? The Lord told Abimelech, I knew that you did all this action out of ignorance. But now, if you want to live again, because you are a dead man, if you want to live, go and restore the wife. Praise the Lord. Now, therefore, verse 7, restore the man his wife, for he is a prophet, and he shall pray for thee, thou shalt live. And if thou restore her not, now, no, not that thou shalt surely die, thou and all that are dying. Do you understand? If Abimelech did not go and restore the wife of Abraham, he will surely die. That is what the Lord was trying to tell me. That he overlooked your ignorance. But today you know the truth. He commands you to repent and restore all the stolen items that you have stolen. All the money that you own. That man wife that you went to marry. That woman husband you went to marry today. Now that you know the truth, go and restore. This is the truth I am telling to you, sister. After repentance come actions. Praise the Lord. So this is what I have to say concerning restitution. So I've given you the message. This is the message the Lord has commanded me to tell you today. If you have given your life to Jesus Christ, you know you are a woman. The Lord commands you to give him everything concerning your life, your body, your soul, your spirit. As you are cleansing the sin in your heart, you are cleansing your spirit from all filthiness of the spirit. The Lord commands you to cleanse even yourself from all filthiness of the flesh, the sin of the flesh. He says in the book of Romans chapter 6 verse 12, he said, let no sin reign over your mortal body. The sin over the mortal body and all this adornment, those bodily attire, bodily adornment, that the main purpose is to seduce. Praise the Lord. According to 1 Timothy chapter 2, verse 8 to 10, you are going to read it at home. The Lord is telling us to lift up holy hands. Holy hands that has no doubt, that will not bring the anger of God. Praise the Lord. The Lord is telling us to dress in a godly manner as women. There must be a difference between Delilah and Deborah. Therefore, your body, which is the temple of the Holy Ghost, must be holy. The Bible says that without holiness, no man shall see God. Holiness in your body, holiness in your soul, holiness in your spirit. So the Lord is commanding all the women in Christ. If you know that you are a virtuous woman, you do not look like an harlot. The attire of an harlot, according to Proverbs chapter 7, verse 10. When you dress as a child of God, in the house, as even outside, make sure that your hair is not palm. Don't palm your hair. Praise the Lord. Do not put any fake hair, hair attachment. It is an abomination before God. When you pray, cover your hair. Hallelujah. For your face, do not use all this powder, foundation, black, any kind of color, brown. Do not use all these eyelashes, the fake contact lenses, the color ones, blue, red. Do not put all these, you know, you trim here and then you put another line. Don't be using it. All those pencil you use for your eye. They are the property of the Queen of the Coast. That is why the Queen of the Coast has entered in the church. So, her attachment is a property of the Queen of the Coast. The product to palm your hair is a property of the Queen of the Coast. Remove it. Remove it. Don't palm your hair again. The way God created your hair, maintain it natural. Put good shampoo. Cream your hair. Don't put any cream like all those relaxers that will change the texture of your hair. Hallelujah. Let your hair grow natural. You can hold your hair like 3, 4, 5 as when you are sleeping. But all this plaiting of the hair, begin to plait. Do not plait it. Praise the Lord. Let it natural. Comb it. Hallelujah. Now, the face, do not use makeup. Any kind of makeup. The lipstick, do not use lipstick. Any kind of lipstick. If your lips is like you have some, you are sick, it's dry, go and see a doctor. They will give you something that will heal it. Hallelujah. But do not use anything because you want your lips to be shining. All these things are the property of the Queen of the Coast. The property of the mother of harlots. You are not an harlot. There must be a difference between Delilah and Deborah. I am telling you, this is the message that God said I should give to you. When you are dressing the top, make sure that your top cover your chest. Because some women, when they put on top, they will leave this area open. They will be seeing the breasts. God do not like it. God doesn't want your breast to be exposed. God does not want your armpit to be exposed. Make sure that you cover. Praise the Lord. When you dress up, make sure that you have well covered. Praise the Lord. Make sure there is allowance in your dress. Hallelujah. Make sure there is allowance in your skirt. Let it be long. Let it be loose. Don't make it tight. Make sure that you wear something that cover and they don't see your shape. Cover everything. Because many women, when they dress up, they will leave this area open. This thing can make men to fall into the sin of lust. When you read the word of God in the book of Matthew chapter 5:28, any man that look unto a woman to law and lust in his heart, he has committed adultery. Don't be a stumbling block for any brother because of your dressing. My dear sister, I'm telling you, this is why many women are going to hell. Your body is the temple of the Holy Ghost. You don't dress to impress the world. Anyway, the world will never love you. The world will never call you its own because you are not from this world. You are a citizen of heaven. So why do you bother if the world do not appreciate you? They don't appreciate the way we dress. It is not their taste, but this is heavenly taste. This is the taste of the children of God. Let there be difference today between a child of God and a worldly woman, between Deborah and Delilah. We are the daughters of God. We are the virtuous women. Let them see Jesus in our dressing. You don't need makeup, my dear sister. It is that ugly woman that will go and look for makeup. The queen of the coast is so ugly. That is why she needs makeup to appear beautiful. But let us allow the glory of God to shine over our body. When they see your body, they see Jesus. Hallelujah. Now, the shoes. I'm not encouraging women to put on high shoes. Because by the time you begin to put high shoes, you can put a shoe that is a bit like this. Not like the length can be like this. Do you understand? Like sometimes some women put very long skirts and they need to put a little bit high shoes that will be, you know, like 4 centimeters, you know. But when it's like this, you cannot even walk. You walk like this. And you see, even the way you walk change. You begin to walk like the queen of the coast, like the snake. You understand? Everything change. This is not the way God made you to be. You walk natural like a child of God. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God bless you. The way you dress, my dear sister. So many women, they will put on skirts that are short like this. And when they sit down, they have difficulty. They will look for something to cover. They will take a scarf. Why are you doing this, my dear sister? You see how you are putting yourself in bondage. God has not called us to live in bondage. You are the one that chose the kind of clothes you want. When you go and see to the tailor, command that tailor to make it long. Praise the Lord. Command the tailor to make it long. I am the one that chose my style. I told the tailor I want it to be like that. I don't want people to see my shape. Today when I walk, let me tell you something that happened to me. Before the Lord gave me this message, you know, I was a prostitute before, as I told you. But when I entered the church, I gave my life to Jesus, but I continued to dress like a prostitute. This day, I was on the street walking after giving my life to Jesus. And suddenly, the bus, a big bus, stopped. The bus driver was calling me, bim, 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 bim. Me, I thought he knew me in the church. Then I crossed the road. I said, yes, sir. Do you know me? Are you a child of God? I entered the bus. He said, oh, I saw you. You are so sexy. I said, oh, Lord Jesus. So you are a prostitute. Open this door, let me go. He didn't want to open the door. I said, if you don't open the door, I'm going to call police. I'm going to call police. So you are a prostitute. I am a child of God. He said, forget, madam. Everybody is a child of God. Me, myself, I'm a Christian. I said, I'm not that kind of Christian. I am a true child of God. This man could not believe me. Then when I stepped down, I said, oh God, why this man could not believe me? Why this man could not believe me? What is in me that this man will compare me to an allot? I don't want anything in my life to make me look like an allot. I was blind, but God was trying to say something to me. When I went back home, I was crying. This woman that was staying in my house said, Claire, why are you crying? I said, look, I told this man that I am a child of God. He could not believe me. He could not believe me. I tried to tell him that I'm a child of God. He could not believe me. He keep on, you know, compare me with an harlot. What is it me that make this man to compare me to an harlot? I don't want anything that will make me remember my past life because I am a child of God. The woman laughed. She said, Claire, I'm not a Christian like you. But let me tell you, the day I will become a Christian, I will not dress like you. I said, what do you mean? She said, turn around. I turn around. She said, look at your dress. That day I was wearing trousers. The trousers was showing my shape. He said, look at your skin. I was somebody that bleached my skin. Bleach. You are seeing the picture of my skin. This is how I used to be. You see, that is me when I'm telling people that this is me when I was in the world. Some of them are surprised. Yes, I was bleaching. The Lord was trying to open my eyes. I knelt down and began to cry. So, oh God, show me Christian that are not dressing like this. That are not dressing like the world. But I thank God the Lord led me in this church. That church. Hallelujah. And he showed me all these revelations. Today, I am happy, my dear sister. Do not allow worldliness to send you to hellfire. Amen. I want you to stick on this television called Complete Holiness TV to follow all our messages. I will begin to teach you what is the sin that are on jewelries. The sin on the all these hairstyle, worldly hairdo. The sin in trouser, the sin in makeup. And I pray that God will open your eyes. Hallelujah. I pray that, my dear sister, your life will never remain the same again. Since I gave my life to Jesus, I never look back. I am going towards that city that the Lord Jesus Christ showed to me, the city of Jerusalem. And he spoke to me. He said, if you read my word and obey my word, he showed me that grace city. He promised to give me that grace city. Hallelujah. I'm going to sing this song. Heavenly rays, I no go tire. Heavenly rays, I no go tire. Heavenly rays, I no go tire. I no go tire. I will not get tired to run this heavenly race. Hallelujah. I am running the race to meet my redeemer. I am running the race to meet my redeemer. Running the race. Running the race. Running the race to meet my redeemer. One day the Lord showed me this revelation. I saw two lanes of women, godly women, the virtuous women in Christ. One in the left, one on the right. All of them were looking towards heaven. And at the end of heaven, I saw a big light. The light was covering the heaven. As these women were standing like this, I was there doing like that, making sure that none of them come out of the lane. Hallelujah. They were marching to heaven. Hallelujah. They were marching to heaven. Hallelujah. My dear sister, are you a virtuous woman in Christ? If you want to become a virtuous woman in Christ, today is the time. Give your life to Jesus and begin to live a new life in the Lord. Abandon all these worldly things. Even if in the church, in your church, your pastor, the pastor wife, is still wearing those things, encourage people to do it. Don't do it. Now you know the truth. Don't allow this message to stand against you on the day of judgment, because on that day, you will give account. Hallelujah. On your own. Your pastor will not stand for you. Your mother will not stand for you. I will not stand for you. Only Jesus. Only Jesus can save. Hallelujah. Only Jesus can save. Amen, amen. Only Jesus can save. Hallelujah. Only Jesus can save. Amen, amen. Only Jesus can save. Hallelujah. Only Jesus can save. Amen, amen. Only Jesus can save. Hallelujah. Only Jesus can save. Amen, amen. Only Jesus can save. Hallelujah. Only Jesus can save. Amen, amen. Holiness in holiness. In holiness. I want to live in holiness. Lord, save my soul. I want to live a holy life. Lord, save my soul. Holy life, a holy life. Holy life, a holy life. I want to live a holy life. Lord, save my soul. I want to live a holy life. Lord, save my soul.
Bye. merci à que tu nous donnes une gloire à l'éternel. Amen, amen, amen. Dis d'amen, mes bien-aimés.
Amen, amen, amen.
Gloire à l'éternel. Amen.